Today I am actually fixing up a furlex 100S, which means it is the smaller version of my furlex 200S or S200. And as you can see, I have disassembled the furling system here. And on this model here, the greasing points is in the bottom here and around here. I can show you the grease points here. Maybe you can see there is a small amount of bearings in there, and they of course need some grease. And also here is, as you can see, grease acquired also here, and then in the A hole there there must also be filled in some grease. Then we have the halyard swivel here, and it is pretty dry, so maybe it is here where the problem is. The problem on this boat here was, of course, it was pretty hard to unfurl the Genoa here. So I have got the little job here today to grease the whole thing up. But I thought it would be a good thing to show you how the system here is looking on the smaller furlex. But I don't know, it seems like there is something wrong here. Maybe there is a part missing or something. It doesn't look totally right. I'll of course start with the easy part. It is of course the top swivel here, and I will then just apply some grease. Maybe you can hear it is sounding pretty dry inside. The bearings is pretty noisy, so I'll then try to put on some grease. And as always, I doesn't apply that much, but let us see if or how much that is necessary. And to demonstrate the angle of the grease tube, it is held in this angle here, so you get the grease into the bearing, and on the bottom one, it is the other way, because when you press the grease in this way, you will then get the grease into the bearings, which is the important part. The top halyard swivel is greased, and I will of course dry away the excess grease when I'm finished. And then I will lubricate the hole in the top, also called the A hole. And it doesn't seem like it have ever been greased. Then I also grease in this point here, but it is important that the grease is at the top of the metal ring there, because if you press down the grease down, you then just press grease under the bearings. It is important that you grease where the bearings is. And it in the bottom here, it also seems like it must be greased on the right side. But in the bottom here, it is pretty easy, because you can then easily see the bearings here. So, and as you can see, they have not been greased at all. So, it is definitely time. The a man in the club has sprayed on a bit of lubrication, but as you can see, it is just dripping around in the surface. So I will then give it a small amount of greasing here to show you the location of the spraying here, or pressing. I press, as you can see, I am pressing in the lubrication from the bottom. Then I am hitting the bearings. So I am filling in the grease into the bearings instead of underneath the bearings. And the lower grease point here, maybe you can see there's a line that is going out here, and in the top of the line there's a kind of a little groove, which means it is here you can then press in the grease, which means you must then press in the grease in the downward position, or the downward way, and then you press the grease underneath and into the bearings instead of just pressing it over the bearings. So I can try to film and press in the grease here. I think the point is that you just press in a small amount, and then you just turn it around, and then the grease will then be put around the whole or all the bearings inside. It is a lot of small rolls inside, so it is just rolling around. I think it is okay. And I of course just saw there is also a small groove here by the line on top, so you easily can grease the bearing here in the right direction and then fill it up with grease. The last bearing we have left is the one in the bottom. And it is of course a bit hard for me to see anything here, so I hope you have an eye on it for me. I think I just press a small amount up here, then we will see if it is enough. I have just used one of my fingers to press the lubrication or grease around here, so the bearing is nicely greased. Then I just need to clean up a bit, and then I will put the whole thing together again. In the top of the A-hole there is this little plastic thing, plastic screw, and you of course just screw it in again. Just screw it in, and it must just be lightly or gentle tightened, because it is just plastic. The furlex drum is on this 100S furlex, made a bit different than on my Bavaria. As you can see, we have a top part here, and then we have a bottom part. The whole thing here is a bit soaked in oil, because they have tried to lubricate it with some oil spray. But in a way it is pretty simple to assemble again. I think I will start to mount the bottom part and then the top part, and then of course the furler drum thing there. But I will of course just clean this part a bit. I have now cleaned the parts, and if you look at the plastic thing here, you can see there is this little hook. It is actually meant to click in place in this little hole here. So you of course take your part here, and then you put it in here, and then you just press, and as you can see, it is then clicked on. You will then of course also take the other part here, and then also just click it on, as you can see. So the system here is pretty smart made. I will then also mount the top piece. Then we have the top piece here, and it is of course made the same way as the bottom piece, with the small plastic hooks. And on this area here we have the holes for the mounting in the top instead. And let us see if it is possible for me to mount it with the camera rolling. Okay, it is clicked in place. Then we just need the second part here. It should actually fit on the other side here. Yeah, as you can see, pretty smart mate. Then I think we just need to mount the drum holder thing. Let us see if it is possible for me to mount the roll thing without dropping it in the water. But you just slide it in the bottom. Okay, I think I must remove the bottom piece. You just slide it in the bottom here. Like that. And then you press it upwards, and it is then mounted. You of course also put in a small screw here to keep it on so it doesn't fly away.